Hi there! Welcome back to Vida Apasionada. My name is Tanya and I'm one of the church leaders here. For the last 3 weeks, we've been talking about life apps. What are life apps? Well, they are certain principles that we can find in the Bible that if we only apply them and practice them, it will make our life really, really a lot better, healthier, and more enjoyable. So, the first week in our session, in our series, we talked about forgiveness. And our main point there was that we are to forgive others just the way that God has forgiven us. In our second week, we talked about confession. And the main point there was that genuine confession leads to a genuine change. And last week, we heard Ryu talk about rest. And he made a really, really good point there, because a rested you is truly a better you. And all the tired mummies out there say, amen, right? But all jokes aside now, what is it what we're really learning here and discovering in this series? It's this one, that application makes all the difference. Speaking of application, a few weeks ago, I was going through my app store, searching for an app, you know, for me and my family to have some fun. It's kind of like a game, whatever. So I was looking through it and then I was like, oh, this seems really nice. You know, a lot of people are raving about it. So might as well download it. Okay, I did. Then I open it and I'm like, wow, or not so wow. You know, it was kind of like not what I expected. And then I just tried it a little bit more and everything, like, no, this is really disappointing, you know. So I just went on to my other apps in the meantime and like, okay, I'm going to go back now and see if I like it better now. I open it again, and just to my dismay, no, nothing has changed. It was the same kind of like boring, not so good game at all in the end. So what did I decide? I decided to delete it, you know? And maybe today we're gonna talk about a life app that you, in your own life, might have been wanting to delete it already, or you have done it already altogether. But you know what? Unlike the app on my phone that I deleted, this life app that I want to talk to you about today is so important that you cannot live without it. It's a bit extreme, Tanya, don't you think? Well, I know it sounds extreme, but honestly, if you don't have this life app, you will never, ever be able to have any kind of meaningful relationships. And don't we all desire to have really deep and meaningful relationships? So, if you're here today watching this and you're a teenager, please, I'm begging you, really, get this life app. Because if you want to have a BFF, or if you want to be a BFF, you will need this life app. Or if you're here and you're single and watching this, please, I'm telling you, you gotta get this life app too, because you will never ever find any meaningful romantic relationship in your life unless you have it. Or you will never find your media naranja, that's what they say here in Spain, right? If you don't have this life app. If you're here and you're divorced listening to this message, maybe it's because you actually deleted this life app altogether already. But again, I'm begging you, please get this life app back into your life. For the sake of your children, for your own sake, for your future relationships, please hear me. Get this life app. And what is it? We're going to discover it now. Interestingly, this life app was discovered way, 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 way before any iPhone was actually in. So even back then, 2000 years ago, it was considered to be so important that the man who wrote almost half of the New Testament actually added a word to that one. It's pretty extreme, just to stress the fact that it is so important. Now, let's see what the Apostle Paul wrote about this life app that we're talking about. Love is patient, love is kind, it does not envy, it does not boast, not proud, da, da, da. Okay, Tanya, I know this verse, it's clear. I've heard it many times. It was in my wedding. Yeah, even if you're not a Christian here today, you probably heard it in somebody else's wedding, because it's 1 Corinthians 13. It's considered to be the love chapter in the Bible, you know, and it's really famous even in maybe romantic movies and, you know, romantic books, whatever you might have heard about it. Anyway, this, I'm sorry to disappoint you though, is not the life app that we're talking about today. So let's skip a few verses and let's go down to verse 7. It says here, it always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. So what love always what? Trusts. Did you catch that life app now? Of course, right? I made it really, really easy for you to figure it out because I highlighted it. Our life app today we're talking about is trust. And by now, you might really understand why I was so extreme in saying that you cannot live without that. Okay, because trust, and even the psychologists out there would really disagree with me when I say that. Without trust, it is really impossible to have a meaningful relationship. It just is. May it be with your parents, with your children, with your coworkers, with your you know, study buddies, your boss, maybe even your bank or the government. If there is no trust, if the trust is lost, the relationship is lost. But wait, wasn't there another word that was attached to that trust? You're right. Here it is, always, that extreme word, always. Why would Paul put it there? I mean, didn't he know that people can, you know, also be breaking their promises? They're not trustworthy all the time. How can God, or how can Paul demand from us that we always trust? Isn't that impossible? You're right, I would really agree. But you know what I think? I think Paul actually meant there that we're not supposed to just trust one time. Imagine that, you know, you get married and then what? Your husband does something that disappoints you and then all of a sudden you're deciding, I can't trust you anymore. I need a divorce right away. No, of course not. So we are to trust continuously, not just once, but always. Well, Tanya, you might say, this sounds really noble. I mean, it's nice words to say, right? To always trust. And yeah, I understand it kind of. But in real life, seriously, I mean, there are just people out there that really do not deserve my trust maybe all the time. Okay, you have a point there. I totally agree. So that's why let's just go to three practical applications right now. And I want to just dive a little bit deeper into the whole thing of this life app. So my first suggestion to you, if in doubt, if you should trust a person or not, is this one. Keep first believing the best. Just keep believing the best, giving them the benefit of the doubt. Because, you know, I mean, it's true. Maybe your friend really forgot about your birthday and it hurt you so much. But have you ever thought about it that she might have just, you know, gotten so overwhelmed with her own life, you know, that she just really didn't even see the event notice on her laptop or on her iPhone? But the thing is, the sad truth now in this day and age, you know, when we have so many bad rumors and there's so many bad things out there about politicians, the former king of Spain, you know, the banks and whatever, you know, our rumors about your neighbors, rumors about your last BFF, whatever it was, we just have the tendency to always believe the negative things about a person right away, rather than to keep believing the positive things about them. So, okay, Tanya, you're just telling me choose believing the best of people. Is that it? No, well, that's where we go to number two now, and that is choose to lovingly confront if in doubt of can I trust this person or no. Now, I have a funny story to tell you about the whole thing, okay? It's funny now, but at that time it wasn't funny at all for me because, you know, we have our staff come over at least once a week to shoot those videos that you're seeing right now. And so, of course, I want to have the place a little bit presentable, right? So that morning, my husband had told me that they would be here at a certain time. And I'm like, okay, I still have time to vacuum. I still have time to get ready, whatever. And all of a sudden, as I was vacuuming the kitchen floor, you know, in my sweatpants and my hairdo, whatever, there was one of our staff members standing right in front of me. And I'm like, oh, I was mortified. I'm telling you guys, it was just so, so embarrassing. Now you can just imagine, at that moment, I started becoming really angry at my husband. Because of course, he's the one who let them in, right? And he didn't warn me. Why? I mean, he should know that I'm not ready yet for them. Anyway, the next day, I kept my horses first, because I was working on this preaching already and I was like learning a lot for myself, you know. And so the next day I had a chance to confront him, like, hon, why did you do that? Like, why, you know? And of course that was wrong all along because he didn't do anything. Turns out, man, he had nothing to do with it. It was actually the children who opened the door and they didn't care if mommy was, because they're used to seeing mommy like that, right? Anyway, to make my point here, what are we usually tending to do? We are just assuming right away of things that people, you know, have done without even asking, without confronting. But so many times it happened to me already that, man, if only I had asked, oh, now I understand, that's why you did it. Of course, you know, that's why it's so much better, guys, really believe me. I mean, nobody has ever said, for example, man, since my wife told me that I don't trust you anymore, our relationship became so much better. No, of course not. Nobody would ever say that. But what we all want to hear and what we would say is, of course, man, since, you know, I really want to trust you, please tell me, explain to me why there's all of a sudden 200 euros missing on a bank account. Can you please explain it to me? Or why all of a sudden are you texting this, you know, guy, my dear daughter, you know, what's happening here? Can you please explain? That is what we are supposed to do first, lovingly confront the people we love. But I know what you're thinking about it already, you know, like, Tanya, There are certain people in my life, though, that I kept on trusting, but it kept on disappointing me, and I don't think they're worth my trust. Well, if it's one of your family members, for example, say your children, okay? So they really lied to you twice this week already. Now, what you ought to do really is to sit them down, confront them in a loving way, find out what it was. If the explanation that they're giving you really is not what you expected, it was not a good explanation at all, then you really ought to, of course, discipline them, you know, appropriately. And then what do? You keep on telling them, hey, I trust you, okay? It's all good now. We're not gonna dwell on it anymore. Or if it's something like that happened with your, say, your coworkers, or you are the boss of a company, and then, you know, people are in your team, they're disappointing you again and again, what you should do really is confront them in a loving way. Arrest that situation right away and tell them, hey, I really have a higher standard of you. What happened there? Let them explain, and then set, you know, again, tell them exactly what you're expecting of them, but then tell them also, hey, I keep on trusting you, of course. You know, I want this relationship to work. I trust you. Okay, but I know, again, like what you're saying, but what if, for example, that's the reason why, Tanya, I trusted my husband, but he still cheated on me. So that's why we're divorced now. What was I supposed to trust him more, even if I find out that he cheated on me? Oh man, I really understand you. Because that happened to me long before I got married to Mel. Actually, that was my first boyfriend did the same thing to me. I found out, I was pretty young, and I found out all of a sudden, just because I didn't want to have sex with him right away, that he had cheated on me. Of course I didn't want to trust this person anymore. So let's go to number three then. Trust people, but not blindly. Because there are really truly situations when you should decide one thing, that this relationship needs to end. So how can we summarize this whole message here? Well, let me give you this one pointer. Trust is a must if you want to have great relationships in your life. Trust is a must in that one. Thank you for watching today.